Bonjour tout le monde. Je veux commencer par remercier le Premier ministre Kishida et le Japon pour leur accueil. Les pays du G7 sont nos alliés, nos amis les plus proches. On a eu une semaine très productive. On a parlé d'économie, de sécurité, de lutte contre les changements climatiques et de plusieurs autres sujets qui sont importants pour nos populations et pour le monde. This week, with our G7 allies, we reaffirmed our support for Ukraine. As you know, on Thursday, Canada imposed new sanctions on individuals and entities that provide military technology to Russia's armed forces or that are involved in ongoing human rights violations, including the transfer of Ukrainian children to Russia. I had the opportunity to speak directly with President Zelensky in person, and I can say it was really great to see him again. We speak every few weeks, but being able to sit down with him as he continues to lead through this extraordinarily difficult time, as he continues to embody the courage, the strength, and the resilience of the Ukrainian people, made it a real privilege to be able to sit down and reconnect with him. He provided an update of the situation on the ground. We talked about how important it was to continue to reach out to partners around the world and friends to ensure the solidarity and the support for Ukraine and for the principles that underpin the peace, stability, and prosperity that we've had in this world over the past many, many decades. What we saw around the table, including with outreach partners, is a solid commitment to obeying the UN Charter, to respecting the territorial integrity and sovereignty of all states, and that is the basis on which we will be able to move forward. Of course, for our part, Canada will continue to support Ukraine and the Ukrainian people with everything it takes for as long as it takes. Of course, meeting here in Hiroshima was symbolic, and it served as a reminder of the devastating consequences of war. This week, the G7 issued the Hiroshima Vision on Nuclear Disarmament, in which we condemned Russia's reckless nuclear rhetoric. The threat of nuclear weapons is also very real here in the North Pacific. Security and stability in the region is an important part of our Indo-Pacific strategy. This is why we announced this week that Canada is investing in projects to help identify, investigate, and respond to North Korea's activities related to weapons of mass destruction. We also announced additional funds for the International Atomic Energy Agency to continue monitoring Iran's nuclear commitments. Bien sûr, quand on parle de sécurité dans le monde, on doit aussi parler de sécurité économique. Une de nos priorités avec nos alliés du G7 est de continuer à renforcer nos chaînes d'approvisionnement. Le Canada va continuer de jouer un rôle clé, particulièrement avec nos minéraux critiques qui sont essentiels pour bâtir une économie propre et résiliente. Que ce soit en raison de la guerre, de la pandémie ou des changements climatiques, on voit les conséquences de cette instabilité sur nos économies et sur nos citoyens. On est tous d'accord qu'il faut aussi continuer de se protéger contre les pays autoritaires qui se servent de leur pouvoir économique pour exercer des pressions injustes sur les autres. C'est pour ça qu'on a lancé cette semaine une plateforme qui va nous aider à coordonner notre approche contre la coercition économique. If we want the world to be more stable, we must also continue to work to close the infrastructure and investment gap in low and middle income countries. We had a meeting about exactly that yesterday, in which we reaffirmed the G7's goal to mobilize up to $600 billion by 2027 for the G7 Partnership for Global Infrastructure and Investment. As a part of this, for example, Canada is investing in projects that include solar grids and village electrification. This will grow the economy and create good jobs for people. It will help reduce poverty, and it will also help fight climate change and achieve our sustainable development goals. Canada has come to Hiroshima to encourage greater ambition and unity within the G7 on a way forward to meet the needs of emerging and developing economies. We are listening and we are taking action, including by working together to make international financial institutions deliver for all countries. Les leaders que j'ai rencontrés cette semaine reconnaissent que notre monde est dans une période critique. Les membres du G7 vont continuer d'apporter de l'aide humanitaire à ceux qui en ont besoin, tout en luttant contre l'insécurité alimentaire. Plus que jamais, dans cette période critique, non seulement il faut affronter les obstacles urgents, mais il faut aussi prendre des décisions stratégiques pour bâtir un meilleur avenir pour tous. Summits like these are an important moment to coordinate our efforts to strive for a better future for all people. In this consequential moment for the world, the G7 continues to be united and resolved.